Hello everyone. So in this video we will see what is meant by adaptive delta modulation. So in the previous video I have discussed about what is meant by delta modulation and what are the disadvantages of delta modulation, that is slope overload distortion problem and granular noise distortion problem. I have discussed in the previous video. Okay, so if you have not seen the video, please check the video. So coming to adaptive delta modulation, it is basically improved version of delta modulation, which is used to overcome the granular noise and slope overload distortion problems in the delta modulation. Okay, so to why the motive behind studying the adaptive delta modulation is to overcome the problems of slope overload distortion and granular noise occurring in delta modulation due to larger value of delta, the adaptive delta modulation is used. So as I said, due to the greater value of delta in the delta modulation, those two problems are arising. To overcome those, we are using delta modulation where the step size delta is increased or decreased according to the input signal x of t. Okay, in this type modulation, the step size delta is changed according to the input signal levels. Okay, so the step size is changed according to the input signal level. So if the input signal level is increasing, then delta is increased. If the input signal level is decreasing, then delta is decreased. So as the input changes, the step size or delta also changes. When the input signal is steep, that is continuously increasing or decreasing. Steep means continuously increasing or decreasing. The step size delta is increased. So if the input signal is something like this, this is continuously increasing, or something like this continuously decreasing, then the step size or delta modulation, the delta is like this. Okay, so the delta is increased in this case. Okay, so when the input is varying slowly to avoid errors, the step size is reduced. So if the input is just varying like this, then the step size is not kept like this, it will be wrong. So it is only kept like this. So small step size for low varying signals, or if the signal varies in a very slow manner. So that's why this is called adaptive delta modulation. So adaptive means changing according to some conditions. It is changing according to the input level or input signal. So that's why it is called adaptive delta modulation. So next we will see transmitter. Okay, so this is how the transmitter of the adaptive delta modulation looks like. All the components are same as that of delta modulation. Just one logic for step size control is increased here. So we are basically increasing or decreasing the delta value. That's why this block is in extra included in this. So delay is as it is, 1 bit quantizer as it is. So the logic for step size control depends on the output of the 1 bit quantizer. So this output will affect the logic function. So it is saying that, and if the output of 1 bit that how it will be affecting the logic of step size controller, we will see. If the output of 1 bit quantizer is high, the step size may be double, and if it is low, then the step size delta is reduced. So if it is positive, then the step size is delta will be 2 delta or increased. We can't say 2 delta, it's just increased. And if this is negative or low, then the step size delta will be decreased. That is, it may be made half delta, 1/3 delta, or 1/4 delta. So depending on the 1 bit quantizer output, the logic block works, and step size delta will be increased or decreased. Okay, so coming to receiver part. So here is the receiver of the adaptive delta modulation, where the basic components are same as it is. Low pass filter, which is cutoff frequency will be highest frequency content, highest frequency in input signal x of t. Okay, so the delay element is given to this one, and then logic for the step size control is here. So this one controls the step size as it is at the receiver side also. So coming to the waveform, y axis is amplitude and x axis is time. Now initially we have drawn like this. This will be our input signal. Okay, so while approximation we will compare here, it is greater than positive. Again we will compare here, it is greater, again positive. And if it is delta 1, it this is, and here we are having a sweep. Okay, so sweep means we have to increase the step size. The step size is increased here, again increased here. Suppose this is delta 2 value, then delta 2 will be approximately 2 times delta 1. This is delta 1 and this is delta 2. So this will be double the this one. So here the logic for step size control comes into action and increases the delta 2 value. So it will become 2 times that of delta 1 value. So like by doing this, we are closely approximating our staircase signal to our input signal x of t. Okay, so here we are having negative. Okay, so when this is decreasing, so we are controlling the step size here also. Here small approximations are made because this closely resembles to the this one. So and this is about how we draw the waveform, and as we can see here, so 111 are for positive and 0 for negative. Okay, thanks for watching.